So now, today we are going to start further the chapter 100 Dresses 2. Okay, so what we have studied in 100 Dresses 2. So we have studied in 100 Dresses 2 that Miss Mason, she has announced in the class that Wanda Pentronsky, she is not coming to school. Why she is not coming to school? It is just a moment, please. It is just because of the reason, because of the fun that has been made by the other student class. And moreover, there was complete silence in the class. So here we are going to start page number 74. In order to make it related to the previous one, I'm reading the last lines of second paragraph. She was a card. At least Peggy hadn't considered they were being mean, but she, Maddie, had thought they were doing wrong. She couldn't put herself in Wanda's shoes. So now Peggy, Maddie was thinking that whatever she is doing is absolutely wrong, and she thought that she should have put herself in Wanda's shoes. She should have thought that if this kind of situation should be faced by her, what would be the result? So, goodness, wasn't there anything she could do? Now she was just thinking that isn't it anything, or isn't there something that she could do? So, if only, just a moment, students are still entering. Yes. Now, if only she could tell Wanda she hadn't meant to hurt her feelings, she turned around and stole a glance at Peggy. So, but Peggy, she did not look up. Peggy, she did not even, and did not have even a, you can say, small hint what Maddie was thinking, right? And moreover, she thought in order to tell Peggy, she turned her face to have a glance, to share a glance, to exchange a glance, to exchange a look with Peggy. But ultimately what has happened? Peggy was not at all paying any attention. She was busy in her work. Well, whether Peggy felt badly or not, she, Maddie, had to do something. Maddie was thinking that I don't know whether Peggy was feeling something bad or not, but finally she has to do something. She had to find Wanda Pentronsky. Maybe she had not yet moved away. Maybe Peggy would climb the heights with her and they would tell Wanda she had won the contest, that they thought she was smart and the 100 dresses were really beautiful. So in her mind, Maddie was thinking that she should at least, she thought that I don't know whether Peggy wanted to go along with her or not. She thought that she should go to Bergen's Height, where she could tell Wanda that she's really smart, she's not a dumb character, and moreover, she's not, and moreover, the dresses that she has made, they were all really very beautiful. So she wanted to go there as she thought that maybe Wanda has not gone away from that place. When school was dismissed in the afternoon, Peggy said with pretended casualness, "Hey, let's go and see if that kid has left town or not." But Peggy, she was also inside thinking in the same manner. Simmer, sit properly. She was also herself thinking in the same manner. She was also thinking that they should go to Wanda. They should tell her. Okay? Peggy tried to be so casual that she's not at all, you can say, worried, or she's not at all, you can say, moved away with this kind of situation, that they should go. But ultimately what has happened, she deeply inside her mind also, she was feeling, yes, this is not the right thing that has been taking place. So they thought, she also pretended and said, yes, of course, we will go to Bergen's Height to find whether Wanda has gone or not. So Peggy had the same idea. Maddie gloated, Peg was really all right. So Maddie was happy that what she has thought, and Peggy had also thought the same. So she thought it means like a nickname. She is saying Peggy to Peg. Dilpreet, sit properly, please. क्या हो गया? Sit properly. So the two girls hurried out of the building up the street toward Boggins Heights. So immediately after the school, the two girls went to Boggins Heights without going to their house. The part of town that wore such a forbidding air on this kind of November afternoon, drizzly, damp, and dismal. Dismal means sad. So this is the atmosphere of the place where Boggins Heights was situated. It was drizzly, light, you can say light drops of rainfall were falling, and damp, there was humidity in the air, and dismal, full of sadness. Well, at least there was no hustle and bustle, there were no vehicles, and there was nothing going on there. Well, at least, said Peggy gruffly, I never did call her a foreigner or make fun of her name. I never thought she had the sense to know we were making fun of her anyway. So deep inside, Peggy was also feeling that something, somewhere, something has gone wrong. She is responsible for her move. So she is justifying herself. She is saying, anyway, I have never called her a foreigner. I have never called her anything or made fun of her name. I never thought she had the sense to know we were making fun of her anyway. She said, but I really did not have any sense that she is making fun of anyone. How is this possible? So I thought she was too dumb and gee is an expression. Look how she can draw. And what she said, I thought that she was dumb as she was not showing any kind of expression. I thought so. But finally, she can draw well because she has won the contest. She said, I have never thought of her in this manner. Maddie could say nothing. All she hoped was that they would find Wanda, and she wanted to tell her that they were sorry they had picked on her. Picked on her means? What is the meaning of picked on her means? Means that they have troubled her. They have tortured her. So they thought that they have never thought that they have done so much of trouble or they have caused so much of trouble. And they wanted to tell that whatever has been done to them, it was not actually just because it was all planned. And ultimately, they have never thought that they are going to make fun of her. And how wonderful the whole school thought she was. And please, not to move away and everybody would be nice. And they wanted to tell her, there is no fun, that no one is thinking of her in the bad name. Okay? So ultimately, no, you should not go from here. And everyone will be nice to you. Actually, they are trying to repent. They are trying to improve themselves. They are trying to improve their remark. So, next, she and Peggy would fight anybody who was not nice. And they also wanted to convey to Wanda that if anybody wouldn't be nice with you, don't worry. We will fight with them. So that she could stay back. Actually, why they wanted that she should stay back? So that they could reform themselves. They could make a change in their behavior for what has been done before. So the two girls hurried on. They hoped to get to the top of the hill before dawn. So the two girls, they went on the way to Boggins Heights, and they thought that they would reach Boggins Heights before dark and they would come back. I think that's where the Petroskis lived, said Maddie, pointing to a little white house. So what she said, Maddie said, hey, look at that white house. I think Petroski family lived there. Wisp of old grass. Wisp means thin leaflets. Okay? These wisps of old grass stick up here and there along the pathway like thin kittens. So here and there, some wisps, tufts of, you can say, thin grass, they were growing here and there. They were seeming like small kittens. And the house and its sparse little yard, sparse means open, that was open and small, that little yard looked shabby, but it was clean. It was shabby, but it was clean. So finally, the yard, or as it is told, now, although she is wearing the same blue dress, but it is clean, not properly, although it is not properly ironed. Okay. So in the same manner, here also the yard also, it is small, sparse open, but it is yard looks shabby, but it is clean. Okay, but it is clean because it is not properly kept up. Okay, why it is not properly kept up? Because there is not pruning and trimming of the trees properly. So it reminded Maddie of Wanda's one dress, her faded blue cotton dress, shabby but clean. So this also made Maddie remember that Wanda's blue dress that daily she is wearing, which is shabby but it is always clean. Why it is shabby? Because of daily washing, because she is having the one blue dress. There was not a sign of life about the house. No one could be seen there, as Pentronsky family has gone away from that place. Peggy knocked formally on the door, but there was no answer. She and Maddie went around to the back yard and knocked there. So what happened? But there was nobody to be seen in the house. Peggy, she knocked formally on the door, but no one answered it. Then she and Maddie went around to the backyard. Then they went to the back part of the house where there was open yard, open space, to look for someone there and knock there. Still, there was no answer because the family has gone from there. There was no doubt about it. The Pentronskys were gone. How could they ever make amends? So now there is no doubt that the Pentronsky family has gone away from that place. And now the thing is that how they are going to make some changes in their behavior, how they will make amends. They turned slowly and made their way back to the hill, now with sad faces, that they have come to make amends, to make amendments in their behavior, to make reforms in their behavior. But what has happened? Now they have to come empty-handed at home. So now they are coming back down the hill. Well, anyway, said Peggy, she is gone now. So what can we do? So Peggy said, finally, she's gone. And now what can we do? What can we do? Besides, when I was asking her about all her dresses, she probably was getting good ideas for her drawings. So side by side, they were also thinking that when I was asking about her dresses, she probably was getting good ideas for her drawings. She is justifying herself, Peggy. She is saying, actually, when I am daily asking for her dresses, it is just because of this reason that she is daily getting the ideas that what kind of drawings she should make about her dresses. She might not even have won the contest otherwise. Now Peggy is making herself responsible that it is because of her teasing only that she was able to win the contest. And how is this possible? So, Maddie turned this idea carefully over in her head. So, Maddie turned this idea carefully. She overlooked it. She did not pay any attention to this idea because for she knew that what has been done is absolutely wrong. What they have done to Wanda was not rightful. It was not at all right. Whatever they have done was wrong. So, but that night she could not get to sleep. But that night was really difficult for her. She was not able to sleep because her mind was tormented by those thoughts. She is again and again pricked by those thoughts in her mind. So she thought about Wanda and her faded blue dress and the little house she had lived in. So what she was thinking of Wanda daily, who is coming to the school wearing the same blue dress. And now the small house in which she was living. Her mind was greatly occupied by the thoughts of Wanda. She thought about her only, and she thought of the glowing picture of those 100 dresses made and all lined up in the classroom. Then she has thought for all the pictures of the 100 dresses that she has made, and all were displayed across the classroom in beautiful way. At last, Mary sat up in bed and pressed her forehead tight in her hands and really thought. This was the hardest thinking she had ever done. After a long time, she reached an important conclusion. Finally, she woke. She got up from her bed and she was not able to sleep. She took her head in her hands in this manner and thought that this is the hardest thought. This is the only thing that I have ever thought and thought and thought. And I want to get rid of it. But she was not able to get rid of it because her conscience is pricking her. She is under burden of her own sense. So, what happened? She finally reached an important decision that what could be done. She was never going to stand by and say nothing again. She thought that she would never again stand by and say nothing again. She would never ever be a part of Peggy's all acts and ultimately would stand and speak in this manner for somebody. Okay, she would not make fun of anybody. If she ever hurt anybody picking on someone means making fun, some unfair treatment. Okay, so if she ever hurt anybody picking on someone because they were funny looking or because they had strange names, she would speak up. She thought that next time if Peggy or anybody would behave in this manner with any other child, then she would definitely, what she would do? She would definitely speak up, stand and speak up what has been done. Even if it meant losing Peggy's friendship, she would really not bother about it. That if it would really make her lose Peggy's friendship, she would not even take a small minute to stop that. So, she had no way of making things right with Wanda. But now from on, she would never make anybody else that unhappy again. She knew that she is not going to make things good for Wanda, or she could not be able to change what has happened to Wanda. But she thought that she would not allow anybody to pass from again similar kind of circumstances or face this kind of disgrace that Wanda has undergone. She thought that she would bring an end to all this, that what has happened to Wanda. So what do you think? What do you think that Peggy and Maddie want after that? What they wanted? Yes. They want to?
For the sin they had.
Okay, for the sin they had made. Or for that, what they will do?
They wanted to say sorry to you.
They have gone to say sorry, but Wanda Pentronsky has gone from that place. After that, what they will do?
I think the second is she will have a change of side of Peggy. And any kind of one she made or other because of their name or their
Or because she would never allow anybody to pick on anybody. If anybody would be suffering from this kind of disgrace, Ron, please, she would stand with her firm decision and would never allow anybody to do that. Right? So, finally, ultimately, why? Why they wanted to do this? Because ultimately, they have come to know that whatever has been done was wrong. That it has been wrong on their part for what they have done to Wanda. And it is just because of this reason that they were making fun of Wanda and asking about her how many dresses she has, that she has left the school forever. And see her action, that they were not able to make even reform for what they have done. So, on Sunday, Maddie spent the afternoon with Peggy. Yes, they both were together. They were writing a letter to Wanda Pentronsky. What was the reason of spending time together? Was that now they have decided that they will write a letter to Wanda so that in order to say sorry and to tell her that actually they did not mean to insult her. So it was just a friendly letter telling about the contest and telling Wanda she had won. They told her how pretty her drawings were. See, Of course, they wanted to finish the matter. But the thing is that they never wanted it to finish in that matter like it has been done. How it has been done? For example, they never wanted it in that manner. How in that manner means they never wanted to say sorry directly. They thought that they would write down a friendly letter only. What kind of friendly letter in which they will only tell that whatever they have done, they will not first of all make a mention of whatever they have done. They will simply talk about contest. Okay, that the contest was organized. She has won the contest. Congratulations. They would say congratulations to her. And moreover, they would appreciate her drawings. Right? So, Simarpreet. So, then, afterwards, they told her how pretty her drawings were. And they asked her if she liked where she was living and if she liked her new teacher. Then finally, they also thought that they would ask her that how she is doing at her new place. Whether she's doing well, she's enjoying her new school, the new place, or the new teacher there also. They had meant to say that they were sorry. Actually, through all these things, what they actually wanted to deliver is that they wanted to say sorry. But their inner self or their conscience is never allowing them to say sorry. Because Peggy was not at all thinking that she has done anything wrong. She thought that it was just because of her asking her again and again how many dresses she has won the contest. But Maddie, she knows that whatever has been done was wrong on her part. So, they had meant to say that they were sorry. But it ended up with their just writing a friendly letter, the kind they would have written to any good friend, and they signed it with lots of X for love. Finally, they ended up writing a letter, and ultimately, they have written with lots and lots of love, like they are writing to a very good friend. How their enemy, she has turned into a good friend suddenly. Just one act of Wanda that has changed everything. She has left the school and has changed everything else. So they mailed the letter to Boggins Heights, writing, "Please forward on the envelope." And because they did not know the address where Wanda lives, so finally what they did, they have written on the envelope to Boggins Heights so that if anybody would be able to find the letter, they must, or his father must have told the postman or the persons living around to forward the letters to this address. And they have mentioned, "Please forward," okay, so that the letter could reach Wanda. Now the question is whether the letter would reach Wanda or not. She would be able to get it or not. Days passed and there was no answer. But the letter did not come back. So maybe Wanda had received it, perhaps. She was so hurt and angry, she was not going to answer. So many days passed, but there was no answer. Okay, maybe they were thinking, maybe Wanda must have received the letter. But, or maybe it is like that she has not received the letter. Maybe she was so hurt that, and angry she was, that she was not going to answer. Maybe she is so hurt and angry on their behavior that she has thought that she's not going to answer the letter. You could not blame her, and they were thinking that we can't be able to say anything to her. Weeks went, firstly days passed, now weeks went by, still Wanda did not answer. Peggy had begun to forget the whole business, and Maddie put herself to sleep at night making speeches about Wanda, defending her from great crowds of girls who were trying to tease her with. So Peggy, she by the time, who is little bit of carefree nature, she is not at all feeling wrong that what she has done to Wanda. So she was feeling that time has passed, Wanda has gone, and everything has passed. But Maddie, who is emotional, sensitive, and he knew, and she knew that whatever has been done was wrong. So she was not able to sleep. Daily before sleep, she was visualizing that Wanda is moving among girls. Girls are teasing her. She's trying to save her. That is in her own thoughts. She is trying to play that role to save Wanda from others that she wished to. But ultimately, she was not able to do it. Right? So, she is also making speeches about Wanda. Don't do this to Wanda. Wanda is a good girl. Or don't make fun of her. It is not right to make fun of everybody. So, in this manner, how many dresses have you got? Like girls, they used to ask her. She would tell, don't make fun of her. And before Wanda could press her lips tight together in a tight line, the way she did before answering, Maddie would cry out, stop! Then everybody would feel ashamed the way she used to feel. So she is visualizing, she is feeling the situation when the girls are standing around her and they were asking, how many dresses you have? How many dresses you have? And when it is height of everything, she would loudly speak, stop all this. And everybody would move away and Wanda would be safe. This Maddie is just thinking in her behavior, in her dream zone. So, now it was Christmas time and there was snow on the ground. Christmas bells and a small tree decorated the classroom. On the last day of the school before the holidays, the teacher showed the class a letter which she had received that morning. So, it was Christmas now, okay? Before the holidays, the class was very well done, beautifully decorated. With Christmas tree and all the hangings around the class. And there were holidays. Now the teacher, teacher again shown the class a letter that has been received. So in the next lecture tomorrow, we'll see that whose letter it was and again what it meant. Okay. So this we are going to do tomorrow. Okay. So I hope that it is clear. Very beautiful chapter. See, sometimes we do such kind of things that we go to that extent that after that nothing is there. We try to repent for our ways, but ultimately what is there? We don't get anything to repent. Okay? And that has ultimately happened with Peggy and Maddie. They were trying to reform themselves. They were trying to feel sorry for their ex. But what has happened? They are not getting any chance to feel sorry. Okay? So next afterwards, we will complete, okay?